County Kids, City Kids, all the kids that make a difference is supported by Visions Federal Credit Union.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the show County Kids, City Kids, all the kids that make the difference. Each and every month, we have highlighted kids of all ages, and we stretch that a little bit. Sometimes it's second graders to maybe college or even beyond college age. And I'm Dave Renninger, the host of that show, or this show. It is really tremendous that we are sitting here tonight, and I'm talking to my guest, and I'm getting hungry as I sit here more and more, because what you're going to see in the next half hour is a young man that has made food very popular, and I guess you can say his profession or his job,
yes.
And I'm very, very impressed with that. So we're going to start out by welcoming Tristen Kochel. Welcome,
hello.
Tristen.
Yep, thank you for having me.
Oh, you're welcome. And we're going to get into all the goodies then, the tots and lots of tots and stuff, but okay. Let's talk a little bit about you first. First of all, you're now out of school, what, about 3 years? High school?
I'm out of school. I'm actually a student at Albright College. I'm a junior. Oh, I'm going to be a senior. And I'm studying business management.
Okay, very nice. And you went to Governor Mifflin, correct?
Yep.
Let's go back.
2019.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
I graduated in 2019.
2019. Yep. Let's go back to those days of high school. And it's not too far back there.
Yeah.
What are some of the things that you personally enjoyed doing throughout your high school career?
So when I was in sixth grade, I played baseball. I played baseball all the way up through high school. I graduated from high school, and I went to play baseball at Albright.
Okay, and you're playing baseball there now?
Not currently. I got too busy with the food truck, so I had to pick one or the other. So
see, here we go. That's the secret,
yep.
the food trucks. So when you're in high school and you're doing your thing in high school, did you ever think of where you are now? And we're going to introduce this to the public soon, but did you think you'd be where you are now with what you're doing?
Oh, definitely not. When I was in high school, I used to talk to my teachers, and I was like, I don't know what I'm doing with my life. I would always stress about that, and I'd be like, I have no idea where my life's going to take me, and I had no idea that this was in store for me.
Well, I'll tell you, for the next 20-25 minutes, folks, if you don't get hungry by listening to Tristen, I don't know what's wrong with you, because it's incredible what he's doing. So let's talk a little bit about you, Tristen, and what you did to get started. What are we talking about? You are now doing what?
Okay, so I own two food trucks. They're loaded tater tot food trucks. We basically do anything on tater tots. So we'll do cheese, bacon, sour cream, scallions. That's our most popular. We have 15-20 flavors at a time out of the truck that we offer.
I don't know. You know, when I heard that you were going to be at Community Days, and I thought, wow, I love tater tots to begin with. It was incredible, you know, how much you can take a tater tot, just a simple little potato,
yep.
deep fried, I guess, right?
Yep.
And make something out of it, and you do. You make it out of almost anything, really. So let's talk a little bit about your business. You have two trucks now, you're saying.
Yep.
So how did you get into, let's go back and start, how did you get into this business to begin with?
Okay, so it's a little long of a story, but I have six pet deer at home, and this all is connected, but I have six deer, and I've started posting TikTok videos with them. And I went viral, it kept going viral, these deer kept going viral, I dress them up. And I wanted to incorporate a business involving the deer. So my family's in the food industry, and I know I have help there. So I got the help from them, and we started a food truck. And then it progressed, got busy, kept doing business, and then we got another food truck.
So now the deer are not part of the food, though.
No, they're not. No, and they're not part of the food. They're just my pets.
Okay. So, all right, then the next 20 minutes or so, we're going to talk about how you make a difference in your community and what you do. And I think it's a really neat idea, because when you think about food, at least for me, people, I love food.
Yeah.
So it makes me happy. It makes me feel good when I eat a food that I like.
Mm-hmm.
So let's break this down a little bit. So let's look at, I guess you have some pictures there.
Yeah.
Let's go to the pictures, if we can do that now, and then we'll come back to discussing some of those pictures.
Okay, so this is Lily, the main... the business is called Pip and Lily's. Lily's the most popular on TikTok, so I incorporated her mostly. This is the picture of our first truck that we have ever gotten. Here's the second one that we just got. I just got up and running about 2-3 weeks ago. And then there's all the deer with the food. There's our like little side logo.
Okay, now let's stop there for a minute.
Yeah.
Talk a little bit about the deer. This is going to sound crazy, but what about the deer? What's in that picture that made you think of them?
Okay. So the one wearing a bee costume, that's Lily. That's a very popular TikTok. I dress her up in different. I dress her up in bee outfits, ladybug, dinosaurs, alligators. I do a whole bunch of different costumes for it, so it's pretty funny. She's pretty popular, but that picture right there is probably the most popular picture, so I decided to put her on there. And then the other deer, I have Belle on the left of her, Daisy on the left of her, and then Molly. And then Luna is the white one, and then on the right is Sadie.
All right, that's cool. So each one is named, and you have them at home.
Yep.
All right, let's go back to... do you have any other pictures?
No, that's it. Oh, okay, wait, one more.
Let's go back to that first picture again before we take those off. This is the one, I guess, not Lily, right? But the food truck is the one that you had at Community Days, correct?
Yep, that's the food truck we had at Community Days.
Within, 2 weeks ago, you had one food truck, and now you have two.
Yep.
So you worked really hard in getting that truck together and getting it on board.
I had a deadline of July 1st for the second food truck. So when I was at Community Days, I was really pushing hard. I was waking up early in the morning, getting that truck ready. And then at night, I would go to Community Days and work. So those were 14, 16-hour days that I was working.
Wow. And it pays off, though, I'm sure.
Yeah, definitely. Yep.
All right, so let's talk about what does it take to operate a food truck. Now, for anybody out there, and me included, we don't know all of this. So let's talk about what does it take to first get the food truck, do the designing, who does that, who does all the inside work in putting all these things together, like your fryers, your food, where do you get your food? So let's talk a little bit about that, because that's special too. And I think a lot of people might think you just take food, throw it in a truck, and you start serving food. That's not the case.
No, it's definitely a lot of hard work. So when we got the truck, I had it decaled. I contacted someone. They got a couple logos. I contacted another person. They put decals on it. And then all the interior, we had to put fryers in. Me, my dad, and my dad's friend all did that. So we did all the fryers, all the propane lines, basically everything in the truck except for the sinks and the stuff that came with the truck.
Okay, so now you're in college, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you're business management major. So any of that in college helping you prepare for the food truck business?
Yeah, definitely. I'm taking courses now and I'm learning a lot. That's helping me, helping with the future of the food trucks.
Okay, and what would you say is the future? What are you looking at doing for the future? Is like, are you going to expand to more food trucks?
Yeah, I'm hoping to expand to more food trucks. I'm always looking for like more things to go off of. So maybe a restaurant, maybe more food trucks. I'm just like trying to expand the business.
What do you think is the hardest thing, Tristen, to keep up with in today's times with the food truck itself?
Finding work. Not finding work, but finding employees to work. Mm-hmm. That's always tough, finding employees. The work is, it's very tiring. They're long. I just worked 19 hours a day, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, so I'm a little tired now, but it's a lot of work.
And you're only 21, right?
I'm 22. 22. I turned 22 in April, yep.
Wow. So a lot of motive, a lot of drive behind what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so let's think about the next, like, where are you going from, like, you were just doing one, you said, show in, where was it, last weekend?
I was doing Reading Motorcycle Club, the bash,
okay.
The annual bash.
So where are you headed next?
So I have a couple big events coming up. I have Maple Grove, I have Fall Fest, I have the Nationals event, but those are the two big ones coming up in September.
Okay, cool. So, all right, let's go back again to high school. We're going to flip-flop back and forth here. Let's go back to high school, or let's go before that. Describe yourself, and I know he's going to love this one. He doesn't know this is coming. Describe yourself as a kid that's in fifth grade, third grade, fourth grade, and Ella back there. I don't know how much Ella knows him at that time of your life. There's a technician here that knows Tristen, so she might be going, no. So tell us your elementary school years, and I'm doing this for a reason.
Well, I'm kind of outgoing. I'm kind of a goofball, kind of the class clown. You can ask some of my teachers, but that basically describes me, just the class clown a little bit.
Ella, is that correct? Okay, thumbs up back there. Well, and the reason I ask that is because when you see Pip and Lily on a food truck, I go, Pip and Lily, and I remember meeting them the first time at a meeting for community days, and I'm going, okay, Pip, I guess, and Lily, and I thought Lily was your mom, and you said, oh, no, no, not my mom. So Lily was the deer. Mm-hmm. So Pip is, how did you get that name?
Okay, so my family is kind of big, like they're big, wide, and big, tall, and I was always the pipsqueak of the family, so my little sister actually gave me the nickname of Pip, like pipsqueak.
Pipsqueak.
Yep.
About 6'2"?
Yeah, I'm about 6 foot now, but growing up I was always kind of smaller and skinny, so... It was the pipsqueak. I was the run of the family, basically.
Wow. All right. So let's talk about a day for getting up and doing, because when I got into school, I knew what my day was going to be like. I knew I had kids coming into my classroom. Joan, you're probably the same way as one of the camera people in the studio, people that you come in and you know your job every day. What's your job? Like when you get up in the morning, what's your job?
Okay. So my day starts pretty early when I have a food truck event. I'm cooking the food, and then I get the truck ready. I have to make sure I have a to-do list that I always check off, so I'm not forgetting anything. But we take the truck there, and then we set up. I have to light all the fryers, light off all the stuff. But and then we serve the food, and then it's time for cleanup at night. But it's basically, even if it's a two-hour job, it's basically all day.
Yeah, I'm sure. And there are. A lot of people, too, might want to know this. There's a lot of food inspectors and food inspections on anything, really, but food trucks especially. Yeah. So how does that happen? I mean, how do you take care of that?
Okay, so once a year, the health inspector comes to check on the truck, make sure everything's good. And then you have some events like community days where they come to the truck to make sure you're doing everything correctly. We did good this year. We didn't have any write-ups, so it was pretty successful at community days.
That's all right. Well, and when you think about it, the small kitchen, like I know my kitchen at home is small, and we tramp on each other's toes sometimes.
Oh, yeah.
So I was watching this at Community Days, and again, that's where I was, so that's why I keep saying Community Days, but I was watching the food truck and watching you, and it's like, oh my gosh, it's incredible how you have this much space and you move around. So how does that feel?
We definitely have practice. I mean, maybe not practice, but... We definitely had experience in there working around each other. So usually it's me, my younger sister, and my mom working in the truck at once. So we're always moving around each other. We got it down to a science where we can have our own spots in the truck, know our jobs, and we found the most efficient way to do it.
And training people, how are you going to go about that?
So I've trained people. I've threw people in at big times where we had long lines, 45-minute lines, but it's pretty easy once you're in the truck. I mean, you just take an order, you make food. The tots are easy. You just fry them. You just know when they're done, when they're crispy, and then it's pretty easy to teach.
And again, like I said, it makes people happy to eat food that they really enjoy. And I was watching that And a lot of people like the tots, and a lot of the people like the food trucks because they're not easy for you maybe to set up and do your job, but it's easy for somebody to go up, grab something off the truck, and go. They don't have to, go through the restaurant. It's nice to have that food truck sitting there.
Yeah.
So what is the worst case scenario, like if you'd be working a real fast-moving crowd? What would be the worst case scenario of what could happen?
The propane running out, electric running out, just anything that's going to stop the production of food. So If a fryer goes out and we're stuck with one fryer, then it slows everything down. The line gets long. People get angry. Hungry people get angry. So any little thing that can disrupt the operation.
Yeah. All right. And I'm going to take a break. I'm going to come back to you in a minute here. And I just wanted to do a shout out to a young man that you may know. Giving Back, it's called. It was in the Reading Eagle. Nick Singleton from Governor Mifflin. He did a tremendous job in making a difference in his community as a football player. And I just read this on Sunday that he is giving back to the community by coming back to the Mifflin High School and running a clinic and running a Shillington clinic for the kids that wanted to play football. And again, it's giving back. You know, and we talk about that a lot in the show, that it's not just sports or it's not just educational, it's not just whatever. It's how you find your niche and how you drive to make that successful. So Nick, shout out to him. He's going to be going to Penn State, and I guess tomorrow he starts his actual practicing and getting ready for the games in the fall. So wish him the best of luck, and hopefully he does a lot of good for himself, but also for the community that he's done already. So a shout out to him. I also had a young man on last month, Xavier Davis, and he was from Reading. Okay. And he did a super job in being a class president, and he did a lot to make a difference in his community as well. And he did a speech, and it was incredible that we could show that speech. So I'm going to ask you, how do you make the difference? And you do, so I don't want to hear, I don't know. How do you make a difference in everyday life for kids or for people in general, besides the food? Okay, I mean, that's part of it.
It can involve the food. Christmas time, I give out free food at Christmas in Birdsboro. So we give free food out there. We do a couple charity events where we donate a portion of our profit to whatever the charity may be.
Okay, really, that's really, really special too. So I did ask this before, but the plans for the future, now you're saying you have two food trucks, mm-hmm. all right? And you're going to continue building on that. You're going to go to college for what, another year?
Yep, I'm in my last year now.
One more year. So again, are you going to stay positioned in this area, feel, or are you going to try to expand? What's your thoughts?
I would like to expand because sometimes the winters get brutal. So driving a food truck and people waiting outside in the freezing cold is not ideal. So I would maybe like to travel down south, maybe set up something there during the winter. But
okay, and again, back to the trucks, the gas mileage today is nasty.
Yeah.
The gas prices are nasty. So what's your thoughts on, like you said about a restaurant before, mm-hmm. are you thinking about maybe positioning a truck and keeping it there for a little bit or making it into a restaurant?
Yeah, I'm looking for all options. I'm still talking about it with my parents, but because my parents, they're big helpers in the business. So I kind of want to set location so that I have like somewhere to be. So some, like when people follow me on Facebook or TikTok or Instagram and they say, hey, I want to come get tater tots one day, and I have a set location so they can just come whenever.
Right. How can they book this truck or trucks if they want to?
So I have business cards. My contact information is actually on the truck. I have my phone number, email, Facebook is where I do most of the booking.
Okay. All right. You have a lot on your plate right now, and I don't mean that as food plate, but you have a lot on your plate. What are some of your goals besides the restaurant or the food trucks? What are some of your goals that you may have had? Because I'm talking to you as a postgraduate now of high mm-hmm. school. And what are some of your goals in the future?
So my main goals, I really focus this food truck. I really want it to work out. I really want it to succeed. So right now, it's primarily just the food truck. I post to the TikToks for fun, but I want to be as successful as possible. So, and I love doing the videos on the internet and making people laugh, make people smile. So it's a lot of fun.
And you talked about your mom and dad and your sister. Mm-hmm. And I know I'm very close to my parents and my sister as well. How did they motivate you to get where you are today?
Just my mom, I've My mom works at Conopoca Catering. I've helped there for a little while. So just kind of forcing me to work at being in the food industry, it got me kind of motivated to do it myself, because I saw that it's possible to make money, it's possible to be successful. So I was like, I'm going to go give it a try and do it myself.
Let's talk a little bit about the financial part of this, because we talked a lot about the food and about getting that prep and stuff, but the financial part, it's got to be hard, at least for me it is, it's got to be hard to think, okay, you're balancing all of the food end of it and making supplies last and buying supplies, but what about the other end? And you see this a lot on your HGTVs and your food channels. What, and then you're in the college program for the business end. So what do you have to do with that? Is it computer based, or what are you doing with that?
I basically do all the finance on QuickBooks, which is the pretty much the easiest way. And then I have my mom's friend that does accounting, that she helps out a lot too with all the financial stuff, because I'm still learning everything, and I take all the help I can get.
So it's the balancing act of all the food end of it and ordering, and then also doing the business end of it, because you got to have that. I mean, you got to know your pluses and minuses and what you can make and where you can make it better.
Definitely.
So what part is it that you would like to do more, the business end, or would you rather be on the food truck? I hear you say a lot about the food truck. Would you rather be on the food truck or eventually be in an office?
I like being in the food truck. It's a lot of fun. I like talking to people, and I like, I had a couple high school kids come up to me and say, oh, I saw you on TikTok, which is always neat to see, and they always, they ask for a picture, they ask a couple questions about the deer, and I love being in the food truck talking to people.
I love the deer idea.
Yeah.
So let's talk about the deer. Okay. So you have the deer out in the woods, or how do you make them?
No, I have them in my backyard. I have a big pen for them. It's about 2.5 acres. So they just live life out there.
And they probably get treated really well, right?
Oh yeah, get a lot of snacks, fruit. They love it out there.
So don't buy any more though, right?
No, I want to get more deer, but it gets a little hard.
Have to have a truck. You have to have a trailer.
Yeah,
a long tractor trailer to put them all on. Mm-hmm. So, all right, and we have a little bit of time left. Let's talk about some of the things that maybe you would tell other people. I always like to do this with my guests. If you were looking at people watching this tonight, what would you tell them and how to get started in a business like this? I mean, you're getting really, really good at it, I'm sure. So what would you tell others?
So one thing I learned is always take advice. If someone's giving you advice, listen to it, take it in, and try to do as much as you can with it, because being young, being my age, you don't know everything, and you have to take all the advice you can get.
Okay, and I always say too about being role models, you're a role model, you know, and I love watching kids come up. I even saw this at the truck over there at Community Days. They were like looking up like, oh man, you know, they were really watching, thinking this is cool, watching you work the truck. So it was really cool to watch that. So I want to also do some thank yous that we have some time. Thank you to the staff here at BCTV. They do a great job. And again, sure-handed a lot, I'm sure. They work hard at what they do. And Vision Federal Credit Union, they do a nice job of putting us on the air financially for the most part, and I thank them for that. If anybody ever wants to come on and sit where Tristen is, you can do that, and you can call the studio. I told people before that BCTV will take your phone number and your name, and they can get to me that way. So, all right, so let's talk then to wrap this up. Your ambition is to do the food truck. It is to do financial end as well as, you know, the food truck industry.
Yeah.
Do you think that, is it going to be, like, will food trucks be popular in 10 years? And I know this is hard, but I mean, just looking or projecting, you know, as my sister says in accounting, projecting numbers and project. Do you think it's going to be?
Yeah, so I actually did a project in college about food trucks, and I did a business plan about this food truck actually, and I learned that the food truck industry is growing and it will continue to grow. So I'm hoping those statistics are correct, because I'm really putting my all into it.
Yeah, yeah. And it's going to be popular, too, in the sense that you have a lot of support. So the more people that see that, I would think the faster it's going to grow. Mm-hmm. You know, and I'm already asking, hey, are you available on Sunday, on September? So you're going to see that start to grow even more. And I think that's going to even be popular here on out because of the industry and the food. It's, like I said, it's a quicker way to get food to people, I would think.
Yeah, it's quick and easy. People, the food comes to you, which is the easiest thing. And corporations are always looking for food trucks so they don't have to go get food. The food just comes right up, park in their parking lot, and then the employees come out and get it. So I think there's always business to be done.
Now that you said that, are you pushing, like here in the city of Reading, are you pushing to get into like businesses and do a two-hour stint where they come out and buy their food?
Yeah, we do a couple events. We do a couple corporations. I did an event for Pepperidge Farm, and it was pretty busy. There was a lot of people, and it was a 24-hour straight event. But we do a couple corporations around here.
Okay, and what was your favorite, or what's your favorite tater tot? I don't think I asked you that yet.
My favorite's the buffalo chicken dip or the Old Bay and cheese. Those are my favorite.
The Old Bay and cheese definitely is one of my favorites I had, and I like the garlic. I don't know what they were.
Oh yeah, the garlic parmesan. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that was really good. So, as I told everybody out there watching us, if you didn't get hungry by the end of this half hour, there's something wrong with you, because unless you don't like tater tots, then that won't count. Mm-hmm. But do you do also healthy? I think I saw that. Do you do a healthy version or something that?
We do a couple vegan items. We do a vegetarian, but it's kind of hard with the cheese for vegans. So we do plain tater tots. We also do some salads and stuff when mm-hmm. people ask for it.
Oh, that's cool. So, well, Tristen, I thank you for being on this evening.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
Oh, you're welcome. And I know that, just knowing you a little bit, I think you're going to be really successful. And I think your parents, I have to thank your parents. Hope they're watching. And your sister, right?
Yep.
I think that they're doing a great job in helping you move along. And at first I thought it was your parents that owned it, and you were helping them. And you go,
no,
this is mine. And it's like, that was neat, because that's what made me think of you as for the show, because it's young people like yourself that are giving back to the community in one way or another. And I think that's special, too. So, but as usual, I love looking out here in Penn Street, you know, and I guess if you worked here every day, maybe it wouldn't be, but that is really special to see that. I love that. It makes me think of New York or one of those bigger cities that you see the people out there walking around and watching the people on the set. Uh-huh. So, but well, and it's been a great pleasure of having kids like you on here, or adults like you now. Mm-hmm. So until next month, thank you, and have a safe and great month.
County Kids, City Kids, all the kids that make a difference, is supported by Visions Federal Credit Union.